If I am eternal, why there are so many miserable conditions of life? And why I am forced to die? This is actually the intelligent question, that if I am eternal, then why I shall remain in this material body which is subject to death, birth, old age and disease? For Krishna, it is that this miserable condition of life is due to this material body. Those who are karmis, means those who are engaged in sense gratification, they are called karmis. The karmis do not care for future. They simply want immediate facilities of life. Just like a child, without the care of the parents, he plays whole day, doesn't care for future life, do not take any education. But in the human form of life, if you are actually intelligent, we shall try our best how to get that life or body where there is no more death, birth, old age and disease. So this Krishna consciousness movement means to educate people for that purpose. Now one may say that if I simply devote in Krishna consciousness, then how my material necessities will be supplied? So the answer is there in the Bhagavad Gita, that anyone who is simply engaged in Krishna consciousness, for his necessities of life, Krishna will look up. Krishna is looking after for everyone's maintenance. Ekajo bahunam idudhati kama, that one supreme person is maintaining the necessities of all living entities. So, for a devotee who is trying to go back to home, back to Godhead, there will be no scarcity, be rest assured. Krishna says in the Bhagavad Gita, Tisham Satudrivdana Yugokhiva Mahamaho. A devotee who is engaged always in my service, I look after how his necessities of life will be fulfilled. Practical example is that in this Krishna consciousness movement, we have got 100 centers. And each temple, not less than 25, up to 250 devotees live. So we have no fixed up means of income. And we are spending in all the branches $80,000 per month. But by grace of Krishna, we have no scarcity, everything is supplied. People are surprised sometimes that these people do not work, do not take any profession, simply chant Hare Krishna, how they live. So that is no question. If cats and dogs can live at the mercy of God, the devotees can live very comfortably by the mercy of God. There is no such question. But if somebody thinks that I have taken to Krishna consciousness, but I am suffering for so many things, for them or for all of us, the instruction is Matras Parashastra Kunti or Sitosna Sukadukkada. This pains and pleasure is just like winter and summer. In the winter, the water is painful, and in the summer, the water is pleasing. So what is the position of the water? It is pleasing or painful? It is neither painful, neither pleasing, but in a certain season, by touching the skin, it appears to be painful or pleasing. Such pains and pleasure is explained here. They are coming and going. They are not permanent. Agama apayana anitya means they are coming and going, therefore they are not permanent. Krishna therefore advises, tāṅ-titikha-sabhāvita, just tolerate. But you do not forget your real business, Krishna consciousness. Don't care for these material pains and pleasures.
कृष्णा कीर्तन गान नर्तन पनौ प्रेमामृतम्बनिधि धीराधीर जन प्रियौ प्रिय करौ निमर्तनौ पूजितौ।